In this illustration, we'll study about electric field inside a cavity. Here the situation says, inside a ball charged uniformly with volume density rho, there is a spherical cavity. And the center of cavity is displaced with respect to center of ball by distance a. And we are required to find the electric field strength inside the cavity at a general point. If we draw the situation here, this is a spherical ball. Would say this is at center O, and we are having a cavity which is off center from this ball, and the center of cavity is displaced by a distance A. Now in this situation, we wish to find out the electric field at a general point, say this point is P inside the cavity, and here we are required to find the electric field. Then how we can calculate, let's see. We are also given that the ball is uniformly charged with a positive charge density rho coulomb per meter cube. And as there is a cavity, we can say there is no charge within this region of cavity. Now, if at this point we want to calculate the electric field, what we can do is, we can find out the electric field by assuming the charge is present within this region also. Then it becomes a uniformly charged sphere, so electric field at this point, say it is located at a distance x or at a position vector x. And here I can write this A over here, that is displacement of a cavity center from ball. So if this position is represented by x vector with respect to center, and due to the whole charge, I'm assuming charge is present within cavity also, the electric field here will be this, which can be written as E1. So here we can write, if we consider charge everywhere in ball, electric field at point P is, this is the point P I am mentioning. So this can be written as E1 vector, and the value we know it is rho x by 3 epsilon naught. I have taken it as x vector because the direction of E1 vector is along x vector. Now say if this point is at a position vector y with respect to the center of cavity, then we can see at this point P only due to the charge of cavity electric field will be in this direction, and say this will be E2 vector. So here we can write only due to charge in cavity region, electric field at point P is, this we can write as E2, and the value of E2 we can write as rho y vector by 3 epsilon naught. Because this electric field will be along y vector because while calculating E2, we are taking only the charge within this cavity region that can be taken as another sphere. So electric field due to this charge will be in radial direction. Now, if we remove this charge, we can directly write with cavity, electric field at point P is, this EP we can write as E1 minus E2. Because E1 is the electric field we have taken due to the whole charge, and E2 is the electric field only due to cavity charge. So if we subtract it, this will give us the electric field with cavity. So here if we substitute the values of E1 and E2, this will be rho by 3 epsilon naught, x vector minus y vector. And here in this triangle, we can see x vector minus y vector is the position vector of cavity center with respect to ball center, which can be written as A vector, which is x vector minus y vector. So here this can be written as rho A vector by 3 epsilon naught, which says a uniform electric field within the cavity region. At every point within the cavity, electric field exists in the direction of A. So if this is a ball within which there is a cavity and everywhere charge is rho, then we can say if this is position vector of cavity center with respect to ball, then at every point inside the cavity electric field is uniform and it is directed along the direction of A vector. So this will be the answer to this situation.